Is that just affecting Oklahoma?
Yeah, 5 civil rights tribes.
I'll call this meeting to order. Roll call.
Barton Ferry.
Here.
Sanders Afton.
Here.
Billy Quayle.
Here.
Item number 3, please. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Item number 4, recognize guests. I want to thank everyone for being here. I think the sign in sheet is going around. Item number 5, new business. Sandra, you got any new business?
Yes, they installed the shields in the offices last week. They look very nice. If you haven't seen them, you feel free to go look. They're real sturdy. Even the ones that sit on the counters are just real good. Karen does want a couple for hers, measured them, and got with Clark at Robinson Glass. He possibly should have it done this Friday. I'll go pick it up. It will be a lot cheaper for us to do that. The estimate, what it went up to, would be around $3,500 with that added on there. Tomorrow around 10 o'clock, Western Waterproofing, have a meeting with him here at 10 o'clock. If anyone wants to come and walk on the windows or any cracks in the courthouse, that will be here tomorrow. Or if you want to walk today for any reason to see anything that you know of.
What's the name of the company?
Western Waterproofing from Tulsa. And the gentleman that is coming, his name is Eric. Ron has been working in Gayla's up on the third floor on her storage room. He's building shelves, but he cannot build them during the day due to the court because it does make a noise for the room that he's doing it in. He wanted to know if he could work a Saturday or a Sunday. I wanted to get that approved by the commissioners so he could get them finished to get that hall cleaned out with the books. Do y'all have, would that be all right with y'all?
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, I'll follow up with him. The jail payment had a difference this month. It was short $3,353.72.
Bill, Don, you got anything to add? Sheriff?
Just a couple things. We talked about the McGirt and Murphy. We've talked about that. That's going to affect us on the law enforcement side. There's some other questions that are out there, part of that we need to follow up with. You guys will reach out to Congressman Mullins. I've been on the phone with him quite a bit. Just reach out and explain to him our concerns. He's very aware of it, but he is willing to talk to everybody one-on-one. So the more we can get, hopefully we can get the ball moving and try to get this fixed. We started 2 programs in the jail for those that weren't here for the other meeting. Started a substance abuse counseling and also domestic violence counseling in the jail. Both those programs have done really well and they're taking off and running very efficiently. Domestic violence is being hosted and funded by Cowboys Women's Shelter, and the substance abuse is by Health and Wellness Center out here at Stigler. So both those programs are going very well. Thefts are up. We've had several side-by-side stolen, had a CDU stolen. We're working both of those out in the west end of the county. You know, what we're seeing is it's, you know, people who's displaced from work right now that don't have work and they're coming out stealing, and we can't be everywhere, but we are working on both of those cases, and we've got some folks identified, so hopefully we'll get some property found and located. Other than that, it's been business as normal.
Chris, you got anything today?
Only that it was Friday before last, I went to Ada and got a big load of supplies, PPE stuff. We've been providing masks and gloves and things like that to the courthouse. Judge Henderson had asked me to get as many as I could, so we have a lot of that stuff in stock now. If anybody in the county is needing it, if you guys need it at the barns or anything, I brought some to Sanders District. If you guys need any PPE stuff like that, let me know. We'll get you some out there. That's all I have.
Okay.
you heard anything more on like the storm damage, the flood?
No, I did. When I was in Ada, I talked to Richard Sonner, and he was, when he talked to me, he intimated that he may be here one day last week, but I never heard from him. He was going to come by and maybe check on some of the stuff.
He never showed up. It's supposed to have been that Wednesday.
Did he call you?
He never showed up.
Now, I had told him that's a possibility that you know, you said he might be here. But
yeah, I haven't heard anything from him since then. That was actually not Friday. It was Thursday before last when I talked to him. But I expect him to show up at some point. And
going to look at some sites.
Yeah.
All right, thank you. There's no other new business. We'll move on to item 6, approve commissioner's proceedings from previous meeting.
I've read the minutes previous. I make a motion on number 6.
I'll second it.
Sanders, Zachary.
Yes.
Yes.
Clark
McCurry. Yes. Item number 7, approved blanket PO, which assists only blanket PO. We have one blanket PO, $2,000 to Sticker Stone out of District 3. Need a motion to approve.
Motion appropriate.
I second it.
Millie Cloud.
Yes.
Sanders Zachary.
Yes.
Clark McCurry.
Yes. Do we have any 324 actions? Okay, well, no action be needed on item 8. Item number 9, discuss, consider signing June 2020 monthly report for court clerk and election board.
Thank you.
and discuss and consider signing court clerk records management and preservation monthly report.
I'll make a motion on number 10.
I second it.
Sandra Zachary?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Bart McLaren?
Yes. Item number 11, discuss and consider the free wildlife services for predator and rodent services for 7/1/2020 through 6/30/2021 in the amount of $2,400.
What time will he spend in the county? I mean, is that a half year or?
It's whenever we call him, man.
Well, it is. I'm going to tell you, in our district, I don't know about the other two as much, but we have used him a lot lately. He has put out traps.
Mm-hmm.
He came by last week and spoke to me. I feel like in our district, and I think he's been to everybody else's, that this has been well worth it. We have even had people that's having more issue with beavers, hogs also, and he has been trapping them more. They've really helped some of the roads where they back the beavers back the roads up the quarter. So
he'll come anytime you call him.
Yes, he comes and he double checks his tracks. He may come and you may not know it unless he gives you a call. But if you know where they're at, you can go by and you know he's been there.
Good.
It breaks down to $800 per district, so I mean, I don't guess you can expect a whole lot for $800. But yeah, he does come and do some trapping.
I feel like it's well worth it myself. I make a motion on number 11.
I'll second it.
Sandra Zachary?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Bart McLaren?
Yes. Okay, moving on to item 12, discuss and consider going out for bids for 8 computers, rugged style and 4 laptops, 8 docking stations with each computer, an external CD, DVD, writable, extra legal drives for sheriff's office.
Should say external drives. it's all right. Number 12, if I can address that real quick, that's the grant that we got. We got a bid in. We called Dale to order the computers. For everything that you needed was $16,000, which was excessive of the $15,000 spending limit that we could have. So we have Dale come back and say, well, we'll sell you these computers, and then you turn around and order your docking stations. Well, that's splitting it. We have $15,000 that has been given to us by that grant. That's a reimbursement. So for us to go out properly, we have to go out for bids, have them do a bid, and then send it back in. So that's the proper purchasing way. we could have, they wanted us to order it two different ways, but we're not. I think that's splitting bids, and I think it's great. So that's why we asked to go out on it.
It's called illegal.
That's what I think. So that's why we're doing it this way.
I'll make a motion we go out for bids for these computers.
I second it.
Barton Clay.
Yes.
Sandra Zachary.
Yes.
Billy Pope.
Yes.
Item number 13, discuss and consider signing renewal of lease agreement for Haskell County Public Facilities Authority. This is the same thing, I mean, for anybody that's here, we discussed in the Public Facilities Authority meeting, just our annual agreement. I don't think anything has changed.
I make a motion on number 13.
I'll second it.
Sandra Zachary.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Barton.
Yes.
Just that one.
Yeah, just that.
That one you already signed last.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then you'll go around with all the places.
Okay. Item 14, discuss and consider signing jail lease agreement for 7/1/2020 through 6/30/2021.
I make a motion for number 14.
I'll second.
Sandra Zachary.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Barton Fig.
Yes. Item number 15 looks like a bid opening at 10:30, so I'm going to skip it for time being, and also 16, and move on to item 17. And that's discuss and consider to approve resolution for 2001 Ford pickup to put vehicle back into District 2 inventory. Sandra?
We went out to sell this truck. It did not sell, so we're putting it back in inventory. I was going through our inventory, and so we needed, since we didn't sell it, just to keep it and put it back in for our paperwork. I make a motion on number 17.
I'll see.
Sandra Zachary.
Yes.
Barton Perry.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Thank you.
moving on to item number 18, discuss and consider approving receiving report number 9 for Robinson Construction for Chalk Formation in the amount of $370,880.02.
I'll make a motion on number 18.
I'll second it.
Sandra Zachary?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Martin Cook?
Yes. Item number 19, sign appropriations, transfer appropriations, check received and bill to be paid. I'll make that motion.
I'll second it.
And we'll go ahead and start this, and at 10:30 we'll stop open bid.
Martin Perry?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Sandra Zachary?
Yes.
As of today, I'm not sure. It's more than 10.
Yeah, it's more than
10. I think it's 13. I'm kind of waving my mind on that.
It's honestly, it's hard to say. The report that I get, I've heard of people that I'm pretty sure have tested positive that are not on that report.
Oh, yeah.
So it's probably higher than that.
But we're also learning that if the blood test, and it was the cold or the flu, that they can't differentiate between the coronavirus and just a hay cold. So I mean, those test numbers are coming back on blood tests, coronavirus, because they can't tell which two it is.
So, and what that means is that there's probably a whole lot of false positives.
It's a mess.
It's a mess. It's an election year.
And then you got folks that are testing positive that have no symptoms, and folks that are sicker than a dog testing negative. I mean, you guys gonna get to call some ball this year?
Well, I don't know.
If y'all didn't know this or not, but he's probably he's an all-star official. He can call some ball.
Yes, he too.
And does a good job at it. I'm really worried they ain't gonna have football season.
And not now.
Bush fan. I'm because election will be over November 3rd and everything will clear up. So we'll get a little bit of sports. Kids might be going to school.
Going to be the miracle cure?
I think so.
Mysterious.
Tell you what's bad, they had a county jail get in their facility, and they've had heck. They had heck. And they were a DOC holding facility, and it
got coronavirus in the facility.
They had over 100 cases instantly. It was a bad deal.
Hell,
somebody's vibrating.
I'm going to say, I'm trying to think, like, that was my sound or not.
Hey, I need some patches.
Me or Terry got it. Terry's got them. I can't remember. One of us got them.
Yeah, if you can get the first one built up.
First one's pretty disappointing.
I should see that. Look at that now. Oh, it came up.
It's clear. It's gone.
Going away.
Hey, the other night, those storms that rolled in, when they rolled in for two different directions and met right here, I thought we was in for.
I did too.
I mean, I'd never seen that. When that boulder just rolled in, met right. I mean, they hit right, met right at Ken almost.
They met at our house.
I'd never seen it.
Coming from the north too, wasn't it?
Yeah, one was coming from the north, one was coming from the east. They just kind of, they merged right here.
I was getting a little bit
angry. That's about every direction.
Yeah.
Yeah. After going to two of them, teacher signs on 71 Highway on West Bend, mm-hmm. And they're blocked. They're setting like that yesterday to the north. On an angle.
That's weird.
Yeah. I mean, and not the facing side, but the skinny side. Both of them, both sides of the highway. What type of thing? Like that.
Paul,
you look at your brother.
It's 10:30. Move back to item number 15, discuss considered open bids for 2008.
2018 or never?
I put 8.
2018 for 3 police packages, lights, sirens at 10:30 a.m. for Sheriff's Department. Okay. We have one bid, Farmer State Bank. Are they just bidding the financing?
Did not have the. Yeah, they're bid the financing on them.
So the
key was here.
3%, well, but I don't see a price. Well, they're not supposed to get a price on the bid.
Yeah, I mean, the price was set. They're not include that.
Well, I may be overlooking.
They put the 3%, and they didn't put the price of the three units on there. The three units are the Kansas units, and they are I have to look on my phone real quick. Units are $28,975. No, they're right. Stand by, I'm sorry. $28,850, I'm sorry. $28,850 is the unit prices.
First times three.
Times three.
Yeah.
At 3%.
So it'd be $86,550.
Yeah. And that's the 2018 Ford Explorers ready to go, light packages and everything. At 3%.
So is that satisfactory to you?
That's what we asked for. That's what we asked for the bid was those units. So we're happy with it.
Make a motion to accept this bid for the first time.
I'll second it.
These on the agenda, those are noted as 2008 model.
2018. She was a typo on her. They corrected the reading.
How many miles did we get out of the last one we bought, 10?
We're still driving. Well, the one's crashed. The other one, we're still driving, and it's got 126,000 miles and came in with 46,000 on it. So we're already at 80+ thousand miles on it. With no mechanical issues. The Tahoe we bought had 43,000, Terry's at 120-something thousand with it, and we've had no mechanical issues with it either. Any of the vehicles that we bought from them, other than the maintaining of the daily use.
Okay, we've got about 10 minutes before the next one, so we'll go ahead and give her.
In case anybody asks what that bill is, it goes to that elevator.
Okay.
You have that Onyx Hunt on your phone, Randy?
What?
That Onyx Hunt, that land app on your phone? Shows you every landowner with their, it's a plat map basically, and it's just like with the assessor, they upload it, and it costs you $19 a year, and you can look at every landowner and everything in anywhere in Oklahoma, where it's like $50 a year for the whole United States.
It's just an app, and it costs, I don't have it.
I don't either.
I only have the free ones.
But you got a smartphone. Randy, how do you get that plane out of the mountains?
I went up there and got some of the equipment out of it with Paul. And I got out. You know, he got killed.
Who did?
Paul Lee.
No, when?
Yeah.
A car crash?
No.
Where at?
Dustin.
Spraying?
It's Friday.
I'd seen on that they had a plane crash. I didn't know. Probably kind of the same scenario, just the temperature change on.
First load out of there on a grass air strip, kind of short, kind of refined area, and clipped the pole. You got, they lasted how long? It was lasting 3 years?
Three and a half years. 3 years.
How much are new units, you know?
Yeah. So to outrig one of those Ford Explorers,
no,
Richard.
I'm talking about a patrol car.
Yeah, they're Ford Explorers. So they're the ones we're getting are Ford Explorers. Same as the PD has. And you're running right at to outfit them and everything, almost $50,000. Talked to Oklahoma Highway Patrol Captain the other day, and he was calling Kansas because he don't know how they're selling for that price rigged out, ready to go. He said, we can't. He said, we can't do it. He said, and he and I actually sent him the contact information to Larry Lewis, the guy at Kansas. And he said, I don't know.
It was on the bottom of that one, but it's different.
Forty-four to forty-six.
I'll keep looking into it. They just come off the back of it.
He said he cannot keep them. Said when he rolls them off, said he's got municipalities and sheriff's offices waiting on them. Said he can't. He said, I can't keep them on the lot.
We're going to move back to item 16 now. Discuss and consider open bids for 2019 Renewer crew cab truck at 10:45 for sure. Is from Young Ford Company. And their bid amount is $31,909.92.
31.9 what?
31,909.92.
And that's a F-150?
2019 4x4.
Give me a 20.
Oh, it says 2019 Renewer. I'm reading the invitation.
Was it 2020?
It'll have a.
It's crew cab.
Yeah, crew cab 4-wheel drive.
Listen, William Chevrolet. It's 2020 4x4 crew cab V8 5.3. Letter, it includes a level kit and window kit tent. And it's $39,950.
Is Well, we can't afford that. That thing, we've got 30,000 that we had for a purchase order with a bid, so we'll have to. My suggestion, we take the cheaper one. It's a four-wheel drive crew cab, and we've already got the purchase order set aside for it.
$8,040 bid, I said, too.
I'll make a motion to accept the bid from Dunn Ford.
I second it.
Really good.
Barton Ferry?
Yes.
Sandra Zachary?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
No action needed on item number 20 and item number 21 is to adjourn.
I make a motion to adjourn.
I'll second.
Sandra Zachary?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Clark?
Yes.